and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, welcome! I'm Girl Meets World and I am so excited to have you. This channel is the place for all things beauty, from makeup tutorials to skincare routines. I do it all. So if you enjoy that type of content, make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you can find out when I drop my videos on every Sunday of each week. So, what are we here today to talk about? Sigma Beauty Brushes. I have went a little crazy and I saw an up to 75% off summer sale that Sigma was doing, and I decided to cash in. Honestly, from the time I started doing makeup, I've wanted Sigma brushes, but I figured I learned about them when I was in college, I think, and I just always associated them with being too expensive, and so I never even really looked into purchasing them again, really. And then I saw that up to 75% off. I said, oh, okay, Instagram ads, you got me this time. Let's jump into it, let's do it. So today we're going to look at all the great things that I got on that haul. And I'm going to also take the time to try to explain what each of these brushes do and exactly how you use them. So first, I'm going to go from kind of smallest to most extravagant to make sure that you stay into the end to see exactly what the big brushes are, like Sigma's top brushes, because I definitely got them. All right, so this is the Praktik brushes, and these are some of the more affordable brushes on the site. I got these because the other sets that you're going to see didn't include some of the items that I knew I really needed from doing my makeup, and so I wanted to make sure I got them because I think these are both great things to upgrade your brush collection with if you don't have them already. Okay, so the first brush is this amazing eyebrow brush pencil, and this is to apply like an eyebrow gel. Some of you guys have seen that I've changed up my eyebrow routine to adjust to this Rona lifestyle, and I've been using Anastasia Beverly's eyebrow pomade, and so this is to brush the brows where you need them to go, and then this you can add that eyebrow dip gel to place on your eyebrows. So that's why I got this brush, and it's super convenient and really affordable. All the prices to these brushes you can find down below. Now, the second from that Praktik collection is this small compact blending brush. It is a flat tapered brush, and the purpose of this brush is to get into those smaller places in your eyelids. If you've seen looks like this, or it looks like this, and you wonder how do they pull that off, they have a smaller brush to make sure that they can control where the eyeshadow goes so it doesn't go too high and it doesn't get all over the lid, especially after you do a cut crease. So this was really important because the eyeshadow blending brushes that I normally have are usually wider, so that's why I made sure to order this from the Praktik collection, because you'll see some of the other blending brushes do not have, aren't as compact as this. Next, I have my Sigma Cream Complexion Kit. Let's open this up and see what's inside. So, great packaging. This is a brush set. The brushes come in a set of three. And the first brush is, in no particular order, this is the Emphasize Contour Brush, and I love this because sometimes when I'm contouring, it goes a little wider than I want. If I want that nice cut chiseled look, when I'm using my different cream contours, I can use this to truly emphasize it and make sure it's going right underneath my cheekbones and not spreading out too much. So I am definitely going to be using this with my Huda Beauty Tantour Bronzer when I contour and get myself that nice chiseled look. The next brush has the same concept. So this is the accent highlighting brush. So a lot of you know that usually when I do my highlighter, I either use my finger or I use a feather brush. And sometimes that goes a little wider than I want. And I really wanted it to be like hyper pigmented when I highlight it, because sometimes I have to add more product. I think this is gonna save me on product and allow me to highlight in an easier way. And the least you have to touch your face with your fingers, the better. You have oils in your fingers, etc. So if you can't use brush, that's the way to go. Next is a tapered kabuki brush. So we're gonna talk more about kabuki brushes in a moment, but this brush is amazing because it gets right in there for your concealer. I'm probably only going to use it for concealer, but you can use a broader kabuki brush all around your face for your foundation, and then use this brush in a corner to get really tight in those tight spaces. But I think this is going to be my new concealer brush. The concealer brush I have now is tapered, but it's a little smaller and it's starting to widen out a little bit. So getting into these harder to reach places right by the eyes is getting a little difficult. And so I'm going to just use this to press the foundation all the way in. And I think it's gonna give me a nice smooth finish. The beauty about these three brushes are that cream face products are in cream blush, cream highlighter, cream contour. So you really want to make sure you have the right brushes versus the ones that were created for powder reasons to apply those different high trending products, cream products. So that's that on the Sigma Cream Complexion box. Next is the Holy Grail. I saw this and I got so excited. This is my Sigma Best of Sigma brush set. This is seven of the best selling Sigma face and brush sets. And it comes beautifully packaged, as you can see. And you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 brushes. I know I just said that, but just for dramatic effect. And they are so beautifully put in. We're gonna just start right to left. Let's take a look at each of these brushes. So we were just talking about kabuki brushes. This is a kabuki foundation brush. Whenever I'm using liquid foundation, I can apply it and buff it out. I do have a kabuki brush from Morphe that I really love, but I feel like this is going to be next level. This is a soft blend concealer brush. Again, if I want to get into some of those tighter spaces, it's tapered like the other tapered brush that I had. And it's just perfect to get right in there for those hard to reach places. It's perfect for any type of application I need from around the face. So super excited to be able to use this as well. If I really, really, really want that perfect seamless contour, I can use my Precision Angled Brush. It's a flat angled brush that allows me to contour or conceal anything that I need to, and it's got a nice angle on it so I can get really close up in here if I need to. And if I'm contouring with that bigger brush and I want to just expand it a little bit more, I can put a little product and brush it out, but still without taking up too much space. So this product I think is going to work perfectly while I do my face routines. The next brush is a diffused crease brush. Again, wonderful blending brush. That's all it is. Everyone's diffused crease. It's a fancy word for saying a blending brush. You can see it's tapered. It will help blend. I would probably use this mostly for transition colors. Now, I talk a lot about blend, 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 pat first, then small circular motions. You need a blending brush. If you have other brushes and you don't have a blending brush, this is the E38. Please get it, like, or go to Morphe, get their blending brush. Like, You need a blending brush to make sure that your makeup is blended out. You don't want, I don't want to put any bad examples, but when you're looking at makeup and you can see the lines, that's not good. Okay? No. Oh baby, what is you doing? But when you see that everything kind of flows seamlessly and you see looks like this, that takes a lot of blending. And so you want a blending brush like this. And you even want to use that smaller blending brush that I talked about to get into those really tight circles. But this is perfect if you have like a look like mine where you're putting in your transition color at the top and you're just blending it out. Perfect for this. You want to use this when adding your transition color, and then after you put your eyeshadow base color on, you want to go back and use this brush again to blend it out. Next is the firm shader brush. This brush is exactly what it sounds like. It's a straight up eyeshadow brush. It's perfect for when you need to pack on different eyeshadows and you want it to stand and pop very well. It applies eyeshadow all across the lid with control, and apparently I'm assuming that using this brush will keep me from having additional fallout for some of the eyeshadow palettes that I have that can fall out. So this allows me more control. If I'm doing a cut crease, I can get right up to where that crease is without worrying about disrupting that line. And I think this is gonna be one of my most used brushes. So again, when you're looking for those tight lined, colorful cut crease looks, you want to make sure that you have smaller blending brushes to be able to apply those. And when you're doing looks where there's a lot of colors involved, you want to make sure that you use a clean brush each time. So I had a domed cut crease brush, but I wanted to make sure that I had another brush, this domed utility, to make sure that if I'm using different colors, I'll have different ways to apply the products. Lastly is the smudge brush. You've seen over the years that a smudged eyeshadow look is really in, or if you want to smudge the colors underneath your eye. I also very often put some eyeshadow underneath the eye just to give it a little pop. This brush is perfect for it. It's nice and small and compact to add those colors as you need them. Next, I have my Sigma Magic Shampoo. This I wanted to make sure I purchased because honestly, one hack that you can use, you can use like a oil stripping shampoo to clean your makeup brushes, or some gentle shampoo to apply to them to clean them. But because I am of deeper skin tones, sometimes it takes a lot to get my brushes clean and it never actually goes back to the normal colors that they have. So I made sure I purchased this. It comes with a little head like so to kind of squeeze it out. It comes with that little head, and they did recommend that I wash these brushes before use, so I do plan on using my Sigma Magic brush to wash them as well as wash some of my other brushes. You want to make sure that if you have sensitive skin or just in general, you are washing your brushes that contain bacteria, dirt, etc. You don't want to just keep using makeup brushes over and over again because it's going to add to clogging your pores, acne, breakouts, etc. So you want to make sure that you invest in a shampoo brush. If you want to see the process on how I clean my brushes, leave a comment below. Okay, girlies, that's it. That is my entire Sigma Beauty haul unboxing. Please make sure to leave a comment below and let me know what something you learned from this video today. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to like it and make sure that you subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you can find out whenever my videos on Sundays are released. Please, please, please make sure you do all of those things. It helps me out a lot as a salon YouTuber. Outside of that, that's all I've got today. So thanks, girlies. Until next time, bye-bye.